I have never been more excited about my life than I am now. And in part, it's because I stepped across this portal when I turned 60.
I think in the Celtic wisdom, most people refer to that pathway as being the babe, the girl, the maiden, the mother, and then the crone. Somewhere or other along the road, I learned that there's another phase in there, the queen phase. And I really like that.
I have been waiting to be an elder ever since I was a child. As a little girl, as a teenager, as a young woman, it was all right, but I always knew that where I was going to be happiest was when I was an elder.
I just think that there's a continuing process of coming into your own, and that somehow or another, that as you get older, it deepens, and there's a better sense of oneself, and I think more confidence in a lot of ways in oneself.
I think this time of my life has made me feel like a grounded person. It's like I have landed.
This is the first time that I can really say I'm making a concerted effort to take time to think about me.
In my practical life, I'm trying to sort my basket. Sort everything that I don't need and keep the essential. It is letting my self, my inner, to blossom. That's where I am. Ten years ago, I could really wake up and run and do things without being reminded by a pain someplace. But now I can feel my shoulder hurting.
First I was angry, like, oh my God, when I read a menu upside down in a restaurant and realized I needed reading glasses. And I was so stubborn, I refused. Oh, reading glasses, that's only for old people. I was in my early 50s.
There's a feeling of seed time, of energy pulling in and the wrinkles appearing.
I mean, she surprises me. I go to the mirror and I suddenly see a wrinkle that wasn't there the other day. I'm looking at it and I'm like, wow.
How your skin looks now and what's going on with veins in your legs. All of the things that start happening at this point that give you pause.
Physically, I'm trying to slow down and take a distance from things.
Couple of aches and pains in the knees, not ready for a knee replacement yet.
How you feel inside is still that young, is still that woman.
I talk to my body. When I feel something, I say, okay, I know you are there, but I need to move on. And we cooperate.
there are some activities that just give me a lift. I love laughing.
You know, I'm writing my book, and it has to be there, and the book is writing itself through me.
Cooking, for example, gives me joy.
I want to continue to dance, and a lot of times that's just putting music on here in my kitchen and dancing by myself in my kitchen. Mm-hmm. It's such an incredibly lovely thing for me and my body, you know, and people laugh, they go, you're dancing by yourself. I go, me, myself, and I, it's the best party going.
I love poetry. I love hand sewing.
I'm very interested in mentoring young people.
I love making love. You make time for love. But I lust for creativity.
I just think that grandparenting is the gift you get for parenting.
Studying, listening to people, you know, having a good life. Those are joys. Yes, things are falling apart, but yes, there is a way of seeing that. It's from the chaos and the collapse that one can emerge. Always, we need to find a reason. Am I deciding to collect my pieces, or am I going to help those pieces to scatter? It is the time where we need to use our spiritual batteries.
I'm really focusing on this queen phase, but also on the king phase, because it's also about really being able to weave freely between my masculine and my feminine, between that strength of the masculine that's quite cut and dried and very clear, and the open receptivity of the feminine that's softer and brings warmth and flexibility to strength.
So joys are everywhere. We have to create joys ourselves before asking the joys from other people. Even though you are suffering, but you can find joy.
I don't think you find peace. I think that's unrealistic. I think you strive towards calm, towards compassion for yourself and others, forgiveness for yourself and others. So even if for one moment in 1 week you have that, I think that's huge, because those are easy to say. They're extraordinarily difficult, I think, to achieve. And it's rife with challenges and setbacks and disappointments, but very, very worthwhile. Very worth it.
a much greater seriousness about the remaining years. It's almost like time to stop playing. I love play and I will always be playful, but there's a seriousness about my being, to represent myself clearly, authentically, and well on the planet. I haven't come here for no reason at all. I've come with purpose, as we all have. And it's almost like now I'm being invited by life to step in fully into who I am.